Hello, everyone. Today we're going to talk about the crops, because there are so many here in Stardew Valley that it's actually overwhelming trying to figure out which ones are the best, which ones are the worst, and which ones have interesting other uses. Even after 100 years in-game and hundreds of hours in real life playing this game, I'm still not entirely familiar with all the crops, so I'm going to do my best today to explain to you which ones you want, which ones you want to avoid, and which ones are just kind of fun to play with. But we're not going to start in fall, we're going to start in spring where everyone starts, because logically that just makes sense. Now, on your very first day, you're going to find that a stranger was in your house overnight. But apparently that's not a big deal because he left you 15 parsnips, which are actually one of the worst crops in the game. A lot of times when I start a new farm, I won't even plant the parsnips, I'll actually sell them to Pierre because they're worth 150 gold and with that you can buy some more valuable seeds. But the reason I would recommend against that is because it only takes 13 parsnips to get your farming skill to level up to its very first level. And parsnips only take 4 days to grow, so that means it's only going to take you 4 days to level up your farming skill, and that's very important because at level 1, you can now make a scarecrow and basic fertilizer. These two are very, very important moving forward. I cannot put enough emphasis on these two. The scarecrow actually works very hard for his money. And by my estimation, he's actually only the third dumbest person in Stardew Valley. You can pretty much ignore water and cannon hoe proficiency because those don't actually really make a difference until you're at about level 10 when you don't need them anyway. And by the way, those 13 parsnips worth 463 gold. But the parsnips are pretty handy due to their 4-day growing period because you get your money back within 4 days, and for spring, it's all about the timing because the crop you want for spring are the strawberries. You get those on the 13th at the Egg Festival, so you need all your money back by then so you can buy as many of those as possible. But there definitely are other crops to play with in spring. We'll take a look at those as soon as you make your scarecrow, because your scarecrow is essential. Without it, all your crops are going to be eaten by the crows and you lose all your money. Now, a scarecrow will cover actually this much space, about 8 spaces in every direction with these huge big areas like this, so it's definitely worth it. You definitely only need 1 or 2 scarecrows to start because the area is so big and your resources are going to be pretty limited, so place your very first one very carefully. Like I said, if you place it right in line with your door, place it right about here just above your pond, this is a giant area it covers. For spring, we have a decent selection of seeds. Now, what you want to buy is going to depend on your overall strategy. One thing I'd like to point out right away, tulips and jazz are very cheap to buy, but you make very little money off them. They're gold per day, definitely not worth your time, and there's no other use for them, so I would avoid doing them at the start of the game because you want money to do other things. If money is important but not your main goal, you might want to go with cauliflower. That's what I often do. It is the easiest. It takes 12 days to grow. You just water it. You can do 2 crops per season. It will not be ready for the Egg Festival on the 13th, however, so you cannot get your money back to buy strawberries, so you will lose a little bit of money there, but you'll still make decent money off cauliflower. Now, if money is your one and only, you're gonna want to go with potato seeds, because they only take 6 days to grow, they have decent money, you'll get your money back before you get those valuable strawberries in gear. It's also worth noting at this point that if you want to get the community center completed sooner than later, it's gonna need parsnips, beans, cauliflowers, and potatoes. And those are going to need to be gold quality, so if you want to get the community center done on the first year, which is hard to do, you're going to want to get some of those going. But not me, I hate the community and love my money, so we're going for profit. But before we actually plant any of these seeds, remember how we leveled up our farming skill? Well, we can now make the basic fertilizer, which is made from 2 sap. You get sap from cutting down trees, you've probably cleared a bit of land by now, you probably gathered some sap, so you're going to want to make as much basic fertilizer as you can. That is worth it for just about every crop you're going to plant to really maximize the value. I know you're probably not going to have enough sap to cover every crop you're going to have at first, that's okay, do as many as you can, try and focus on the more valuable crops like cauliflower and strawberries. And at the end of every day, if you have a little bit of extra energy and time, just cut down some trees, you'll get the wood from it, and collect the sap especially because it's all about the money. In order to get your cauliflower to potentially turn into a giant cauliflower, they simply need to be placed in an area that gives them at least a 3x3, so a total of 9 spaces, and they have a small chance of turning into a giant one. The benefit of a giant one is, if you break it with your axe, it will give you more cauliflower than what the 9 spaces would normally give you. That one gave me 17, so it almost doubled the area it's used. Also, if you're not in that much of a hurry to harvest these cauliflower, once they're matured, you can continue to water them and they will still have a chance to grow into a giant one. Once the 13th finally rolls around, you've hopefully gathered quite a bit of money, and now you can buy those valuable strawberries. You just get them from the shop where Pierre set up here, they cost 100 gold each, well worth the money. Yes, they are expensive, but you will get your money back. Don't worry about that. Now, once you've got your strawberry seeds, you don't need to plant them that day. It's going to be pretty late by the time you get back from the egg festival. You can plant them the next day, but don't take too many days to do it because you're going to get 2 harvests out of them actually for the spring. Once you plant them, they'll mature after 8 days and then every 4 days after that. So that's 2 harvests, but don't waste too much time. Otherwise, you'll only get 1 harvest and lose a lot of money. And that's normally my crop progression for year one. I do the parsnips and roll those into potatoes, into strawberries. That will make you the most money. Just be careful on your timing. Make sure you have the money for the 13th, and then you plant the strawberries soon after. That way you get your money's worth. But those aren't necessarily your only options for spring. You could try the other seeds that Pierre sells. You'll make money off any of them, just not as much. And the traveling merchant who shows up right here every Friday and Sunday will occasionally sell you other seeds. The one we'd be looking for early in spring is the coffee bean. If we happen to find one very early on, it will cost 2,500 gold, which yes, is expensive, but if you can't afford it, it will absolutely make you your money back. Also, it's probably worth buying a rare seed anytime you find one. If you can afford it, they are expensive and you won't get your money back until fall, but it is worth your time if you find one. Unfortunately, today she doesn't have a coffee bean, so I'm gonna go have to cheat one into existence. Coffee beans also have a small chance of being dropped from the mines from the little black fuzzy dust sprites. Now, the coffee beans are quite rare for year one for spring, but if you do happen to find them, the reason they're so valuable is they take 10 days to grow initially, and then they're ready for harvest every 2 days after that, and they produce multiple coffee beans after that. So I can continually replant these, make a giant coffee crop if I want to, and it will grow really big, really fast. So if you are lucky enough to get a hold of a coffee bean in the early game, you've really got your crop choice made. Just keep expanding on coffee. Now, if you're amazingly lucky, you can get your hands on an ancient seed in your first spring. You'll occasionally find them from these little worms in the ground, so always carry your hoe on you. Always hoe up those when you find them, because if you find an ancient seed in your first early days of spring, you will make a lot of money off it and be a very happy camper. One of the amazing things about the ancient seed is it'll grow through spring, through summer, all the way into the very end of fall. It spans all 3 seasons, so if you plant them in early spring, it will make you so much money you won't even know what to do with it all. They do take a long time to grow initially, 28 days, so you might want to use some speed grow on them. Fertilizer loses its effect after a while. Speed grow is the way to go, speed up that profit. 28 days and every 7 days after that, so once a week, it will produce you 1 ancient fruit, and these are very valuable. You can sell them, or you can wait till level 9 farming when you have a seed maker and start multiplying them. People love these in the greenhouse in particular because they'll keep producing endlessly. Every week you go in there, harvest it, make 100,000 gold. Easy, easy, easy. Another choice for spring, which is actually fairly valuable if you've unlocked the desert, is rhubarb. Rhubarb are pretty valuable, take 13 days to grow. It's worth your time unless you have access to the more valuable stuff like coffee or ancient fruit. That concludes spring seeds. So if you're lucky enough to find coffee or ancient seeds, prioritize them first. They're your money maker. Other than that, plant those parsnips, roll those into potatoes, into strawberries. That's how you make your most money. Let's go find summer. Before we do that, here's a little bit of emphasis on the value of these things. Single ancient fruit, 550 gold. The coffee beans, they produce multiple per plant, so there is 558 gold for those. And those will go every 2 days. Once we move into summer, we'll find that most of our spring crops have died, unless they're multi-season crops, like the ancient or coffee. Or if they're some of the giant crops, they'll hang out forever, so that's kind of cool, but they're also kind of in the way, so let's get rid of those. That's much better. Let's go look at the summer crops. If you're anything like me and all about the money, blueberries are the only way to go for summer. You should have lots of money by now. You should be able to buy lots of these. Buy lots of these because they'll make you the most money. They'll take 13 days to grow initially, and then every 4 days after that, they'll give you more money. Just keep going, load up on blueberries. And every season has a chance to do the giant crops. This one is melons. Melons are actually pretty good money in themselves too, not quite as much as blueberries, 12 days to mature, and they have the potential to be giant. Still doesn't make up as much money as blueberries, still pretty good. Who doesn't like big melons? And just like spring, there are some crops that are not worth your time. The flowers, just like spring, are not worth much. I wouldn't bother with flowers unless you happen to want them for something. They don't really have much of a use, especially at this point of the game, so I wouldn't even consider them. Wheat is also not very valuable. It only takes 4 days to grow, so it's kind of like parsnips. It'll make you a little bit of money. It will do it quickly. You cannot eat it, get any use out of it, except for a few things. You can use it for a community center bundle, and you can turn it into things like flour and beer. So that gives it some use. Again, for the first year, I wouldn't really worry much about it. Corn can actually be fairly valuable if you plant it in the beginning of summer because it will run through summer and fall, but the more you wait, the longer you wait, the less time it has to grow and produce, the less money you'll make. So it's something to consider, but you're gonna have to babysit it all the way through 2 seasons, so unless you're prepared to do that, don't worry about corn. The rest of the seeds here are somewhere in the middle. Plant them if you feel like you want them, something to play with, something different to look at. Tomatoes aren't bad. They're used in a lot of recipes for a lot of things. They're middle ground with value. You'll make some decent money off them, not a huge amount. Every seed here, you will make money off it, just not as much as others. Once you hit year 2, you'll get new seeds from Pierre for every season. One for summer is red cabbage. It's actually pretty valuable, almost as much as blueberries, something to consider, but that's year 2. By then, you'll have it figured out. Do whatever you want, it's your life. And again, of course, valuable seeds come from the desert. If you do happen to have it unlocked, well, the summer seed you want to go for is absolutely the starfruit. This is definitely the one of choice if you have access to it. The starfruit seeds have such a nice blue color to them. And remember how I said how important the scarecrow was in early spring? This one scared off 14 crows already. That means 14 plants would have been eaten. That's 14 plants that would not have given me money otherwise. Like I said, one scarecrow does this whole area. It's madness. So summer, pretty straightforward. If you're about money, all about the blueberries, go straight blueberries. Don't forget though, there is a community center bundle to complete if you want to do that. That requires tomatoes, hot peppers, blueberries, and melons. So if that's something to consider, well, go ahead and plant those. Other than that, it's all blueberries, unless you have the desert and then it's all the starfruit. And I'll show you how much this is worth, about one scarecrow's circle, whatever you want to call it, worth of starfruit. Keep in mind that these valuable monsters are unfertilized, so I only got 15 gold quality, 185 regular, and 32 silver. The better quality of the fertilizer, the more gold and silver quality you're gonna get. Like I said, always worth fertilizing, especially if you have extra money, just buy the fertilizer if you have to. Fertilize things. By the way, as you're harvesting all these crops, your farming skill will go up and up and up to the point where you can make sprinklers. Even at only level 2 you can make sprinklers. I would recommend it because I hate watering things. Sprinklers for everything. Anyways, all those starfruit, they were probably expensive to buy, but they made me 185,000, and that wasn't a very big crop at all. That's lots of money to play with. So by the time fall rolls around, you should have more than enough money to fill your entire field with all sorts of crops and whatever stupidity you want. If you don't, you should stop stalking the villagers and get to work. Thankfully, again, fall is pretty straightforward with regards to the crops. The most valuable one are cranberries. If you're going for money, just do cranberries. If you're looking for some community center goodness, you're going to want corn, eggplant, pumpkins, and yams. Those will take care of your community center needs. Once you make it to year 2, Pierre will sell artichokes, which sell for almost as much as cranberries, still not quite as much. Also, the grapes are almost as much as cranberries, so they're another option too. Pumpkins as well. Pumpkins are the ones that can turn into giant crops in fall, so we'll see if we can make that happen while we're here. Some of the seeds you'll want to avoid if you're looking for money would be the fairy seeds. The fairy seeds, like any flower, don't sell for a lot. Given that it's fall, they will still make you decent money. And I think they actually have a chance of producing a fairy once they're matured, and what a fairy does is will instantly mature other crops around it, which can be pretty big and pretty beneficial. Sunflower seeds, unfortunately, only produce sunflower seeds, so I don't really see the point. And bok choy sells for the same as the fairy flowers, but they're still actually pretty valuable, so might be worth your time. If you want a bit of variety, go ahead and plant anything in fall. It'll all make you decent money. But cranberries first, and then things like pumpkins and whatever else you want to do. Unless, of course, you have some of the rare seeds. If you do, plant those, make them grow up. It's your choice to sell them or not sell them after that. I would recommend putting them in a seed maker and multiplying them, because once you have a crop of those going, you'll never need to do anything for money ever again. Hey, look at that, we got two giant pumpkins right on top of each other. That's kind of cool. So these are what the pumpkins look like matured, and these are the finished product of the rare seed. They turn into the sweet jamberry. So for fall, if you have the means to do so, it's all about the sweet jamberry. They are so much more valuable than anything else that it's not even a comparison. I'll even show you the value. Being that the pumpkins are about the second or third most valuable crop you're going to have in fall, they're not that far off of the most valuable cranberries. I'll pick all these, and then I'll pick all the sweet jamberries over here, and then we can compare them. Basically, when I start a new farm and I'm working towards new crops, I'm always aimed for either the ancient fruit or the rare seed, the sweet jamberry. Keep working towards those two, get a seed maker as soon as you can. You should have that before too long if you keep doing bigger and bigger crops. Once you manage to get a sizable crop of either the sweet jamberry or the rare seed, you don't really have to do anything else after that money-wise. You can continually focus on whatever you want. Now, the comparison. And farming, of course, things leveled up because the more valuable the crops, generally the more experience you get. So feel free to make your choices along the way. I won't get too much into that in this episode. So, for farming, those gave us 26,312, which is actually better than I thought it would. But the sweet gem berries, considering there was, I think, three times less of them, made us almost three times the money. So you can see the immense value of those. And they're not even considered a fruit or a vegetable for some reason. But there's a value. Those were unfertilized, by the way. If you're going to do sweet gem berries, fertilize them. Use the best quality fertilizer you can get your little hands on. Fertilize them, you'll make so much money that you don't know what to do with it all. That was about 85,000 gold total, by the way. So that about concludes the crops for year one. You start out in your spring, parsnips to potatoes to strawberries. Pretty straightforward. Feel free to play with that recipe as you see fit. In summer, pretty simple, blueberries. In fall, pretty simple, cranberries. That's likely going to be year number one. For year number two, you can probably start getting into ancient fruit and the rare seed. And once you start getting into those, that's all you need to ever do again. Don't worry about anything else, just those two, unless you want to. But if you're like me, you're all about the money, those are what you go for. If you want to learn more stuff about Stardew Valley, all sorts of tips, tricks, tutorials, stupid stuff, whatever, check out the rest of my channel. Hundreds of videos of all that kind of crap right in there. Other than that, hope you liked it. Thanks for watching.